Hi and welcome back. In this video, we're going to talk about how to format navigation lists inside of HTML and CSS. And you can see here, I have the index.html page open, and I've actually deleted everything that was there and entered in this text, and you're going to want to go ahead and do the same. You can see this is just a simple unordered list with a series of links inside of it. And you can actually call these anything you want, but then we need to actually create pages for these lists to links to actually go to. Now obviously we already have index.html, but I need to create the rest. So I'm going to come up here and I'm going to right click right on my top folder here and select new file and do about.html products .html services.html and contact.html. And you don't need to put any text inside of these. You can if you want, but we just need some page for these links to go to when we actually click them. Now, when we're talking about formatting links, there are actually five different states that a link can be in. There's the normal state of a link, the visited state of a link, the active state of a link, and then the hover and focus states of the link. And you've seen this before because on a lot of websites, the links by default show up in that navy blue color. But you've probably noticed that if you click the link and then go back to the page, those pages that you visited, the links that you've clicked, now become like a purplish color. And that's the difference between a normal link and a visited link. You can control all this with CSS, and that's what we're going to see in this video. The active state of the link is the color of the link when you're actually clicking on it. And again, by default, that's usually a bright red color. The other two states of the link, the hover state is when the mouse hovers over it. And again, you've probably seen examples of that. And then the focus state. And the focus state comes about when the keyboard actually has focus on that link. So if you use the tab key to tab around different areas of the page, the focus link property or the focus state of the link will appear. And most people don't do that, but a lot of times people with different kinds of motor disabilities that can't use a mouse, that maybe use a keyboard or an alternative to a keyboard, that can really help them. So five different states: the normal state, the visited state, the active state, and the focus and hover states. Now, there are actually, when we create our navigation element, we create it inside of an unordered list. And this actually allows us three different structural elements that we can target to format the link. We can target the UL element, the LI element, and then the A element. And that's necessary to get different kinds of effects. And you'll see that as we go through this video. I'm really quickly just going to go ahead and preview this in Google Chrome. And you can see here we have our links. And again, you're going to notice that there are some different colors. When I hover over them, they turn orange. Several of these are red and a couple are green. And let's go ahead and take a look at the reason for that. I'm going to go ahead and open up my style sheet here. And you can see I formatted my anchor tags with the five different states. And you can see the normal state of the link is a green color. The visited state of a link is this red color. And again, if we take a look at this, you know, red and green. If I was to actually click on products and then go back, you'll see products becomes red at this point because I visited that page. So four different states, and again, the way you specify the state for your link is you open an anchor tag style, and then you do a colon and link for normal, visited for the visited state, and so on and so forth. So I could come along here and I could change my links to being whatever color I want. A lot of times people make the normal state of the link and the visited state of the link the exact same color. For example, I'm going to go ahead here and just go into Dreamweaver's color selector here. And I'm going to say my normal links are going to be this shade of blue right here. And I'm going to make that the exact same thing for visited and active. But then when I hover over it, I want it to change its color. And let's say the color I want to change it to is going to be red. And again, a lot of times people make the hover and the focus state the same color because effectively they serve the same purpose. Just one for people who use the keyboard to navigate around and the other for people who use the mouse to navigate around. And you don't need to specify all these different states. If you don't specify it, it'll just use whatever the user's browser default is. And let's go ahead and preview this again in Chrome. And you can see they're now all that blue color, whether they've been visited or not. But when I hover over them, they change into a red color. Now let's go ahead and change this around and make this a little bit different. And in this example, I want to actually make our links colored squares. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete all this, and you can see I've included my universal selector here, my asterisk, and I've removed all the margin, padding, and border from my elements, so I don't need to do that individually. Now, the first thing that I want to go ahead and do is I want to make sure that my links don't show up with bullets next to them. And again, because I took the margin off of my list, you won't see a bullet, but it actually is still there. And in some older browsers, it actually will show up. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to target all of the LIs that are inside of UL tags. And I'm going to use list style type and set that to none. So that's the first thing that I'm going to do, is I'm going to make sure that my bullets don't appear in older browsers. The next thing that I want to go ahead and do is I want to go ahead and format the A, or the anchor, the link itself. Notice in this case I'm not specifying the state of the link. All I'm doing is specifying that to target that A. And you could also do this if you wanted to just target your links that are inside of an unordered list. You could do ULLIA just like that. And that's often very helpful as well. But just for clarity's sake, right now we'll just format our anchor tags. And the first thing that I want to go ahead and do is I want to set the background color for my links. So I'm going to go ahead and select background color as my property. And the color that I'm going to go ahead and select is just going to be this medium blue color right here. And I'm going to go ahead and close that off. And let's go ahead and preview that in Chrome. And you can see that those anchor tags now have a blue background on them. And notice we haven't affected the color of the link itself yet. We're going to do that when we specify the different states. But we can see that we have a background color. But we have a little bit of a problem here because each one of the buttons, or each one of the links, is a different width. So we want to go ahead and change that so that they're all an equal width. So I'm going to come back here into my style sheet, and I'm going to add a property in here. I'm going to say width, and then I'm going to set it for 200 pixels. And let's see what that does. I'll switch back in here into Chrome and refresh, and nothing happens. And in an earlier video, we talked about the fact that there were numerous display properties for different elements inside of HTML. And this is actually one of the concepts that is the most important, but oftentimes the most difficult to grasp when you're dealing with CSS. While there are lots of display properties, the two display properties that you're going to be using the most are display block and display inline. Now, by default, most elements that you work with display in a block format. P tags, H tags, things like that, div tags, those are example of block level elements, meaning they take up their own line. Other elements, such as images or spans, or in this case, anchor tags, are what we call inline tags, meaning they don't take up the entire space on a line. They just take up the space that that element normally would take up. And that's the reason why when you do a paragraph in HTML, when you end that paragraph and start another one, it starts it on a new line. But you could insert a link, an A tag, right in the middle of that paragraph, and it wouldn't break the line for you. So inline elements, the element stays in line with whatever it is contained by, but a block level element takes up its own line. So let's go ahead now and come back here, and I'm actually going to delete the width property here. And I'm going to set the display property to block. And let's see how that changes our link. I'm going to go ahead and refresh this. And now you can see the color extends all the way across from one end of the page to the other. That element is taking up that full line on the page. Now, when I said it takes up the full line on the page, it takes up the full width or the full line of the page unless you specify a width for that element. So I'm going to come back in here, and now I'm going to add back in that width property of 200 pixels. And now when I save this, you can see that those elements are limited to just 200 pixels. They're all still on their own individual line, which is what we want, but you can see very easily how they've been restricted to just that particular width. Now, the next thing that I want to go ahead and do is I want to put a little bit of padding around these items, and I actually want to make the width a little bit narrower. So I'm going to come in here and I'm going to specify the width. I'm going to narrow it down to 150. And I'm also going to apply some padding onto these buttons. I'm going to put 5 pixels of padding on the top and the bottom, and 20 pixels of padding on the left and the right. And again, you'll remember if you specify just two values for margin or padding, the first value is left and right, I'm sorry, the first value is top and bottom, and the second value is the value for left and right. So let's go ahead and save this, and then preview this in Chrome, and you can see I now have some spacing above and below and on the left and the right. You actually can't see the right, but it is there. So now let's come in here, and now I want to change the color of the actual text that's inside of the link, and I actually want this to change color depending on whether or not we're hovering over those links. So I'm going to go ahead and create an A-link style, and I'm actually going to type these out first, and then I'm going to do visited, and then I'm going to do active, and then I'm going to do hover, and focus. One thing you're going to find very quickly as you start to learn HTML and CSS is there are certain pieces of code that you reuse over and over and over again. And a lot of people create a scratch file, and that scratch file grows and grows and grows with just snippets of code like this. And later I'm going to show you an example of one that I've created for myself that you can get. And you'll remember to specify the font color. We use the color property, and I want the color to be white, and that's 3Fs. And I'm going to specify the exact same for my visited and active state, but then I'm going to go ahead and change the color to something different when we actually hover over it. And in this case, I want it to be this very light orange. And I'm going to do the exact same thing for my focus. So I'm going to go ahead and save that. Come back into Chrome and refresh it. And you can see my links have now become white. When I hover over them, they become that light orange color. I also want to remove that underline from my links, because the hover effect is enough to indicate that that actually is a link, and I don't like the underlines. A lot of people don't like the underlines. So I'm going to go ahead and remove the underline. Let's try that on the A tag and let's see if that works. And that's going to be the text decoration property. And you can see with the text decoration property, you can do an overline or you can do an underline. There are some other styles in here, but the one we want is none. And I'm going to go ahead and save that. And then I'm going to come back into Chrome and refresh it. And you'll see the line now disappears underneath that. So you can see we've sort of got the start of a navigation bar going on here. And you can do, you know, anything you want at this point with that. I could set the font family to something different like Arial. I could set the font weight to bold. You know, and then when I refresh it, you'll see the difference there. I could set the font size if I wanted to. I could put a bottom border on my links. Border bottom. And I'm going to say this is going to be a 1 pixel light gray, which is 3 C's, solid border. We'll go ahead and save that. Come back in here and refresh. And now you can see I've got little dividing lines for my links. If I wanted to give myself some space in between my heading and my navigation list, there's a couple different ways we could do that. I could set it on the H2 and give the H2, which is right here, some bottom border. Some bottom padding, or I can assign it to the UL. And Either way, I'll get basically the same result in this particular criteria, but I'm going to say padding bottom is going to be 20 pixels. And now you'll see some spaces in there. And again, all the properties that we've learned about, font size, 12 pixels, all of those will work in the case of formatting your links. You can also, and you've probably noticed this, you can also change the background color of the box that forms the link. And I could do that, let's say on the hover state. I could come in here and select background-color, and instead of being this medium blue here, I'm going to make it a little bit darker when I hover over it. And this allows you to select a color. I did that a little quick. Let me go ahead and do that again. I'm going to go ahead and select the color option from my drop-down list, and then the little color wheel right here. And then you can select a base color from either here or here, and then change the brightness or contrast right here. So here I'm going to make that just a little bit darker. And now we'll refresh that page, and you can see the effect that I'm getting there. Now, what if instead of wanting a vertical navigation, you wanted a horizontal navigation? For example, when we're in Manchester template, here I don't have vertical navigation, I actually have a horizontal navigation bar. How would I go about setting something like that up? And let's go ahead and come back into our style sheet here. And I'm actually just going to go ahead and delete the styles that I've placed in here. But you can see I'm leaving the selectors alone. That way I don't have to retype all of that. We'll save that. And again, I'm leaving my universal selector and my H2 alone also on this. And now when we go back in, we could see I'm back to just a normal list of items. But again, going back to what we talked about when we referred to the display properties, whether something was displayed as a block level element, meaning it occupies its own line on the page, or an inline element, I can come here and I can say display inline, or I can type display inline. Won't do any good if I say it. So display inline right there. And let's go ahead and come back in here. And you can now see how the different elements are lined up horizontally instead of being stacked on top of each other. That one item does a whole lot for us. And I can come in here and set the padding, do different things like I've done before, like we did in our previous example. I can say padding is going to be 5 pixels top and bottom and 10 pixels left and right. And now you'll see how I'm able to space those out if I want to add a background color onto these. I could do background-color, and I could select a color that I want to use. Whoops, come back in here, and now you can see I've got that background color on my links. If you want to change the way the background color appears when you actually hover over these items, you can do that as well. I'm going to take this background color off of here, and I'm actually going to place it on the individual link states, and then I'm going to go ahead and pick a different color for hover and focus. And now when I go ahead and refresh that, you can see the actual block changes color, just like that. But the main thing that I wanted you to take away from the second part of this really is that display property and how the display property gives you the option of either stacking things in a block format or listing them side by side in a horizontal fashion. And I'm going to actually show you one more example of that. I've just gone ahead and copied some text, and I'm going to go ahead and create a paragraph here and just paste that text in. And remember, you got to close your P tag. And I'm going to copy that and place it on here again. And again, this is just random text. And when I go ahead and take a look at this in my browser, you can see those two blocks of text there. And again, when this paragraph ends, since P tags are block level elements, the next P tag moves down to its own line. But remember, A tags, anchor tags, are inline tags. They're not block level tags, which means I could come along, and I'm actually going to go into design view for this to make it a little bit simpler. I'm going to go ahead and highlight this text right here. And I'm going to go into my properties panel here. And I'm just going to say this links to index.html. You can see that it created a link there. You can tell by the background color and the font color has changed. But you can also see, and you can even see the padding that we put left and right and top and bottom on this. But you can see that it didn't start a new paragraph at the beginning and the end of the A tag. That tag was inserted in line with the element that contained it. And again, we're going to see lots of examples when we work with the Manchester design and the Krakow design about that. So if this doesn't make perfect sense to you right now, don't worry about that at all. Just know that there are those two differences in the way we style different elements, block and inline. And there are actually more than that. But for this tutorial, we're just going to work with those two fundamental display styles, block and inline. In the next video, we're going to talk about the CSS positioning properties. And this is actually going to be our last CSS tutorial before we actually dive in and start back in on working on our Manchester project. The basic CSS tutorials are almost over. We're almost at the point where we're going to get to the good stuff, where we're able to actually see our page come together. So the next video is going to be on the CSS positioning properties, and we'll introduce you to those, and then we will start in on the CSS for our Manchester project. I'll see you in the next video.